There's the Chromecast, Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Apple TV, and now we have the Bigify. The question I'm going to be answering on this video is, what makes the Bigify different? Hey guys, everything technology here, so let's get right into it. The Bigify's main goal is to turn your TV into a giant Android tablet, or whatever you want to call it. When I first saw this device, the first thing that came in mind was a fat flash drive. I bet you feel the same way. Anyway, there's not much of design, but the whole device is plastic, the cheap kind, which is a disappointment for the price of it. Moving on, here on the top of the device, we see a Bigify logo. On the back of the Bigify, here we have some air grills to help it to cool down when it heats up. Trust me, this device gets really hot. Now on the top, we have a cover covering the HDMI adapter. Looking on the bottom, there is a USB port where you can hook up your flash drive for expandable storage. Also on the right, there is a micro SD card slot for expandable storage. On the left, there is a micro USB port for powering this device in a little circle opening that I'm not really sure what that is. Powering this device is a dual core A9 processor with a gigabyte of RAM. In addition, this device has 4GB of internal storage, and it can be upgraded up to 128GB with a micro SD card. As you can see here, Temperone is performing okay, and there's a little bit of lag. Actually, a lot of lag, but it's not as bad as it will be if you're playing Modern Combat. Don't even try to play graphic intensive games like Modern Combat because you will crash this device. Furthermore, this device struggles with multitasking as it tended to lag when I had about 3 applications running in the background. The Bigify is running stock Android 4.2 Jelly Bean. Basically everything you do on an Android phone or tablet, the Bigify can, like rooting, getting on social medias, etc. However, it won't do it as well as other devices because it has a dual core processor. Another thing is, the Bigify comes set to 720p, but you can change that to 1080p, which I don't recommend because the Bigify will be extremely slow. On top of that, there were a lot of random crashes. Like when I launched a live media application, every time I would try to load up a TV station on the Bigify, it would crash. That is something you're going to have to look at before purchasing. To connect your Android or Apple device to the Bigify, the first thing you need to do is go to the App Store or the Play Store, find the Bigify application. After that, hover over to the Bigify and connect it to the HDMI port. Next, hook up the USB cable to the Bigify and the power source. Go back to the application, search, and connect. That's simple. Now I'm going to be showing you guys how the application looks like, and it's going to look like the same exact thing on your Apple devices, like the iPad. Anyway, so here on the top, that's where we have all the navigation keys and stuff. So this whole thing right here is a trackpad for it. Basically, if you don't know what the trackpad is, it's a mouse pad, same thing. And also, you could choose to use a mouse pad, or you can have it as where it's just like you're using it as a touch screen and you just have to look on the display to make sure that you're doing it right. And every time you touch a screen, it takes a screenshot of the display and it sends it back to this phone, so it is very slow. It's not like lively recording it and sending it back to your phone, which kind of sucks. And then here's a menu bar, which allows you to press the home button, go home and stuff like that, exit, and even like you could as an exit as an application, go to settings and change things up, and also go to menu. And the cool thing is when you play games, it actually uses the vibration and even the sensors from the phone. And also here is Virtual RC. You could also use this as a gaming controller for certain games for the Bigify, which you can get it from the Bigify App Store, which is on loaded on the Bigify. And also this is basically a controller for the Bigify itself. As you've seen, the Bigify isn't the best and not the worst. Now you're wondering if I recommend it. To tell you the truth, not really, because of the price point. I feel it's too expensive for what it has to offer. If I was you, I'd rather go for the Chromecast or something else. Speaking of the price point, this device ranges from $60 to $100. The link will be down below in the description if interested. Thank you guys for watching my review of the Bigify. If you did enjoy it, please subscribe and give me a thumbs up. Also comment down below if you have any feedback. And remember, this is Everything Technology, where technology is everything.